So, Ed just messaged me and told me that this ship would blow up here. And here it is, here's the comet report. He's telling me, no, you won't analyze my ship. And no, I don't. Because he blew it up already. Oh, he had 6 ships? I thought he only had 5 ships here, and this was the 6th. That means no, he was chasing it. Oh yeah, there you can see the torpedo damage doing 1 point to the armor, and most goes straight into the hull. Does this do any damage? Oh no, I don't see any of them damaged. Did they have point defense? Yeah, they had point defense. Maybe point defense actually killed one of the ship. Killed one of the missiles, or the one missile that this thing shot. I haven't really seen the point defense work though. So, that ship's dead. Never actually made it through the warp point. But no matter, we have this little ship that can do this for us. Where did that combat take place? Down there. So if he moves here now, he's going to have this little ring as sensor range, so I think we should move here and we'll be fine. Afterwards we probably don't even need to cloaker then. No, there's still nothing behind this point, okay. So we can move the fleet through. An alternative to moving the fleet through, I should add the ship here. Oh, does this have PD? Yeah, it has PD, that's good. An alternative to moving the fleet through is just waiting for him behind this warp point. But then it'll be a long while until we are through this system and through the other one. So I think our mission is going to be getting to that warp point here for now. And you are also going to do the same. You have others coming here to stand guard behind that warp point. Okay. So that scout can go with us. Right, then we have the bunch of warships we have over here. No, I think I'm going to keep just the slower warship here, and the other ones are going to go catch up with the fleet. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, let's move them there. Yeah, okay, that is 3 turns for them. The other asteroid colonizer, I think we sent the first one to the large belt, so this one is gonna go to that one once we have loaded the fighters. Did I hit load? I think if you click on drop but then hold the mouse key and then drag it to load, it'll load still. Fighters, oh yeah, and it's load our fighters. And then colonize there, remove the load population order, and that's it for ships orders for now. We were going for, oh, there's extra cloaking devices too. We were going for the extra stealth and sensors afterwards. Oh, we can actually get it in one turn. Oh, we can only get it if we invest 100% of our research into it. Well, that's pretty rare. But I'll take it. Do I wanna build something else? Yeah, resource situation is still not looking better than it did before. What does that medium stealth plate look like? Medium stealth plate. Used vehicles between 1400 but smaller than 1600. It's due to dodge. Prevent sensor sweeps below level 2, so only the level 1 sensors that he actually has right now will be blocked by this. It won't be blocking level 2 sweeps. Ah, I see. So unlike the normal armor, this does not have an equal value to this one. The slight stealth coating will actually block level 2 scans. more expensive? No, I don't think so. No, this one is a little more expensive, the medium one. So putting this on here isn't exactly a high priority, and since we're not building any, let's just leave it at that for now. Or are we building any? If nothing else, we should be building gunships. Let's design a gunship that has the missiles that we developed last time. That's a mine. That's a corvette. Okay. Copy you. Light stealth coating. Oh, right. We had lower decks on this damn thing. Light stealth coating is something that you can use. It doesn't add much to the cost. And we want to use missiles with you. Yep, looks fine. Need a little bit of extra crew. And then we're going to put an extra ammunition and an extra armor plate. We're also going to use 25 ordnance, so 50 ordnance every 6 seconds. Which means that this is 9 volleys. Better would be better, but it'll do. And we've determined that fusion torpedoes or torpedoes in general... Oh, hold, this is nuclear, not explosive damage type. Well, the explosive damage type was good against ships that just have armor because it penetrates most of the armor. But we have to look at what the nuclear damage type does. Halt. Hardening of the arteries. Heaves. Hemorrhage. Yeah, sure, whatever. They are IT range? No, they're definitely a 40 range thing. Which means the artillery mounted guns that we have on the others are much higher range than this. Much better for kiting, which is not something you'd expect. But the damage type. We have for the damage type. And they're going to be Base Guardian 40. Should they be? Yeah, they probably should be. So what does that nuclear damage type do? Nuclear damage type also penetrates shields a little bit and armor a lot. Huh. Well, if you ask me, that looks pretty damn similar to explosive. Description is a little little different. Explosive damage inflicted by bombs and missiles partially penetrates both shields and armor, though not as much as kinetic or energy damage. And nuclear, similar to explosive, but also kills many more population and crew. I think there's a population modifier that you can give these, I'm not sure though. But crew killing? I don't know. Maybe there's a special effect that'll kill crew. Wasn't aware that you could make damage types that had a special effect like killing crew and applying regular damage. So, do we want to build a few of these in the carrier? It's gonna be cutting it closer with the money we have left over. Well, we can't put a stealth plate on this thing, that's for sure. There's 900 cargo space, so we can't even put very many on them, but 6 of our new boats we could put on there. Let's put 6 of them on here. Or should we mix them with these artillery mounted mass driver ones? No, I think if we go for something, we should not mix the damage types. So, missiles it is. And then a hospital. Damn, those things are pretty expensive. Something I've wondered is if it's really more efficient to build these gunboats and carriers for them, because these carriers are so expensive, as opposed to just building medium and small warships. Honestly, probably not. But these things, with their 4 speed and their combat speed bonus, are going to be having a significant speed advantage. Wonder if I should even bother putting that much armor on, but it's just 8 kilotons of armor. Well. Since he didn't have any kinetic weapons, as far as we could see. Well, we're building something again. I think all my colonies were still busy for at least a few turns. Yeah, you look busy. Okay.